Welcome, VC.
This is Todd Guy, the thrashing zombie here with messed up hair. back with another video. This is a contest entry for Brian's Vinyl Records channel, his 100 subs contest. It's like a lot of other people that have been doing the contests. I'm fairly new to his channel. I found him through watching other people's contest entries. He knows stuff about records, and he's got a nice collection of what he's shown so far. And I'm not sure how long he's been doing it, but he seems like he knows his stuff. He's doing a contest. Music of our childhood or something to that effect. Basically, it's four questions. Show one or more items of any media, of music you listened to when you were in grade school, and then music you listened to in middle school, and then music you listened to in high school, and then music you listened to in college, or if you didn't go to college, music you listened to after high school. So, yeah, with me, I didn't really start listening to a lot of music until probably the 8th grade, middle school. Excuse me. I did listen to some music. I had 8 tracks when I was in grade school. I had some 7-inch singles, which I don't have anymore. Well, first one I remember listening to was this 8-track tape of Kiss's Rock and Roll Over. And there was another one, I think it might have been Alive, but the tape broke on that. But this is the original 8-track that I actually listened to. I'm surprised this is still fairly nice condition. I have a whole box of 8-tracks my mom had in her basement. Some of them I listened to. Other ones. This one is the one I played a lot, though. I also have the record of that as well. Rock and Roll Over. So I remember listening to Kiss. It was a big thing, you know. A lot of, in the U.S. anyway, a lot of little kids, elementary kids, for some reason got into Kiss, probably because of the makeup. This is another one that I remember listening to. I got this for a present or just something. I don't remember what. But everybody knows Kiss, and they know Alive 2. This isn't my original copy. I think I mentioned in another video, my original copy I cut the inner sleeves, the pictures out, and in a fit of anger or something, I broke one of the records, and the whole jacket was beat up. I mean, this isn't in perfect condition either, but I found this. Mine didn't have all the stuff that came with it, you know, like poster or anything like that, so it might not have been new. I don't know. That was really all I can remember listening to in elementary school. I listened to other stuff, too, that on the radio my parents would listen to. My mom, actually. My dad was kind of out of the picture. She would, like, stuff on the radio. You know, stuff at the time. That was the late 70s, early 80s. Yeah, late 70s, early 80s. So, what's classic rock now? You know, the Aerosmith and the Badfinger. Badfinger. Foghat. Bad Company. Steppenwolf. Supertramp, I remember hearing Take a Long Way Home. I can't stand Supertramp now. So that was elementary school when I was younger. Into middle school, sorry. This one might have been, well, this might have been elementary school. I'm not sure when this came out. I don't know where my glasses are. I remember hearing the song You Got Lucky Might have been elementary school, might have been middle school, I don't know. But I like this album too. Trying to think. It's another one. U2's War. Sunday Bloody Sunday on it and New Year's Day. I really like those songs too when I was younger. I'm assuming this was elementary school as well. So I think this came out before I was in middle school. Era of MTV, the 80s, you know? Duran Duran was huge as well. You're like The Wolf, Rio, Planet Earth, Girls on Film. I don't really remember the song Planet Earth, but the other three. This is actually a 45 speed extended song versions. They're, you know, 5-6 minutes long, I think. No glasses, I can't see a damn thing. I'm actually gonna go get those. Hold on a second. Hello, it's glasses. So, yeah, let me see. This is 5.5 minutes for Hungry Like the Wolf, 6.5 minutes for Rio. Yeah, they're kind of long. These, I must have been in middle school. I heard these the first time. This came out in 82. But I don't think it was until 6th or 7th grade, I think, when I first saw this video on MTV. Scandal. This is their EP. It's just called Scandal. Yeah. Saw the song for Goodbye to You. I just fell in love with this. I don't know what it was. At the time, I wasn't really... This is a gold stamp promo as well. Middle school, I hadn't found my musical taste yet. I was just listening to whatever was on MTV. Along with that one, was Scandal's Warrior, which came out in 1984. So in 84, I was 11, so I guess I was still in grade school. Yeah. So, but I don't think I heard that song until middle school, though. I fell in love with that Warrior song as well. Another one from, must be around grade school as well, because... I remember watching this before we moved to California, which was in 84. Yeah, this was 1983, so I was 10. It's Pyromania. I remember watching these videos on MTV for Foolin' and Photograph, and what was the other one? Rock of Ages. I think my mom actually had this cassette. I think those are all elementary school stuff, right? Everything else is later. Yeah. So, when we moved to California, didn't listen to a lot that I can remember, just stuff that was on MTV. I remember the Bangles were huge when I was out there with Walk Like an Egyptian and Manic Monday. What else was big? Can't even remember. I wasn't really getting into music. I think the Beastie Boys had just come out when I moved out there. California rap was coming into it. You know, Fat Boys were huge. Run DMC was pretty huge. I can't think of anything else I would listen to. Salt and Pepper was just coming out. Didn't really, I listened to the songs on the radio and MTV, but not really gotten to them. It wasn't until we came back from California in 87 or so, or the early 88 maybe, that I started getting more into music. I remember, I think it was in California when I first heard a song from this album. And we got back, I asked for this cassette for Christmas. That's Def Leppard again, Hysteria. This is a huge album. I played this album to death in a set. It was great. I mean, I can take it or leave it now, but I wanted it in my collection just because. Along with that, after I got into that, I started watching more MTV, getting more into music. And around that time, this band came out with this album, Poison. Open up and say, ah. I remember hearing their first album, Live With The Cat Dragged In. I heard their love song, I Won't Forget About You. I Won't Forget You, or something, whatever that song was in the first album. I heard that out in California. Didn't really like it. Hadn't heard any of that album, but I saw the video for Nothing But A Good Time for this. I just had to get this. And then not too long after that, I think this was 87. Anyway, Guns N' Roses, Appetite for Destruction, came out. Maybe that came first. Yeah, I think this came out in 87, so this came out first, and this was 88. So I must have heard this first. Welcome to the Jungle. So this got me into the glam hair metal. What else do I got here? Sorry. Let's see. Along with that, White Lion's Pride, I was listening to. That was 87 as well. This is big on their top 20 or top 10 at 5 or whatever it's called for videos. Song Wait was near the top all the time. Def Leppard, Pour Some Sugar on Me dominated that for weeks. Number one. But this was like number two. Sometimes it jumped up to number one. Pour Some Sugar on Me always came back. That was 1990. Wow. Sorry. And then also listening, I found Dangerous Toys, self-titled, which was, why did they put the dates on here? Here it is. Oh, 1989. So, actually I was in high school for this one. So we're moving on to high school apparently. I think that everything else is, yeah. So I jumped ahead a little bit here. My whole timeline screwed up. I don't really remember when I first started listening to this stuff. So anyway, going into the ninth grade, I was just listening to a lot of glam metal. You know, Motley Crue. Listening to Motley Crue. You know, this album. Theater Pain. I also got into their earlier stuff. Shout of the Devil and Too Fast for Love. I mean, Girls, Girls, Girls came out around 87, 88. So I was really into the glam metal. And then Dangerous Toys. You know, 89, I said. Yeah, 89, got into them in high school. Slaughter. First album, Sick It To Ya, which was 1990 actually, along with Warrant's Cherry Pie. I should have graduated in 90, but I stayed back in the second grade for some reason, I don't remember why. And then my senior year in high school, I couldn't graduate because I was missing 3 credits, so I had to go back for 3 classes. So that bumped me, maybe it was 91 I was supposed to graduate, but bumped me up to graduate in 93. So I was still in high school for these 2 albums. Man. Okay, well, still in high school, I started hanging out with another bunch of people. Not a bunch of people, couple of people that were into the heavier stuff, like Metallica and the Anthrax, and that made me look for more heavier stuff. Started off, you know, Megadeth, Peace Sells. Listen to that. I still needed heavier, so I saw Trip of the Brain on MTV. So I bought this album. This is one of my grails on vinyl. I'm looking for one of these on wax, man. I need this. It's not cheap that I can see anywhere. Overkill. This all leads back to watching MTV's Headbangers Ball. Seeing the song for Elimination. This is another grail for me on vinyl. I just had to get it. I've been Overkill fan ever since this album. Suicidal Tendencies, I mean, I like that album and a couple other ones. Then, and also in high school, this was a huge part of my high school years. Mostly the junior year. This was, doesn't say the date. Man. Gotta be 80 something, of course. 89. So that's about the, might have found that a little after. Was I a junior in 89? No. I don't know, but. This was when I was driving. Having trouble with this case. I don't want to close. There we go. But yeah, this was a huge part of my high school years. Paradise was a song that me and my crew listened to a lot. It was like our official theme song that we would listen to. And then when the 90s hit, grunge started to come in. I got into Nirvana. Listened to some Pearl Jam. I don't really listen to Pearl Jam anymore. I still like this album a lot. I mean, find an OG copy of this would be awesome. I could buy a reissue of this. I almost did. There was one in Newberry's that was still sealed. I think there was a backstock and the corner was bent. It was damaged. It was like $20. Passed it up. I went there yesterday and it was gone. So whatever. But I got into the grunge a little bit. And then after high school, I got into a lot more other stuff. A friend of mine listened to Rage Against the Machine a lot. First album. Some weirder stuff like Smashing Pumpkins, I think I listened to. Screaming Trees. We were comic book nerds, all of us. So we heard the movie The Crow was coming out. We had to go see it. I fell in love with the soundtrack. This is the Record Store Day. Reissue. The first time on vinyl. Pro soundtrack. So when I heard this was on vinyl, I like lost it. I was so excited. So I got into this album a lot in the 90s. I still have the CD. So that was after school. Didn't go to college. And then between some of these other people, I also listened to Saigon Kick. Not this album per se, but the Lizard, which has some songs in here. From that, it has The Lizard, All I Want, Love's on the Way, and Hostile Youth. I don't have the CD, but we did listen to Saigon Kick. And we kind of, that group, we didn't really listen to a lot of really heavy stuff. Got into some Armored Saint, John Bush, Anthrax, some other stuff I can't remember. I went through a period where I didn't listen to hardly any metal. I was just listening to the older metal they had, like the Metallica, Anthrax, the Slayer, Megadeth. Nothing really else. I did get into this band. Zebrahead. This is MFZB. Yeah, MFZB. I think it stands for Mother Effin' Zebrahead. Or Zebra. I'm not sure. Got into this by playing a wrestling video game on the PlayStation. They had a couple songs on there that would rotate the songs. This must have been really later. I think this was like 2000s or something. I don't quite remember. Like 2003, I think it says. So yeah, that. And as I was getting older, in the mid to late 90s into the 2000s, I just kind of listened to whatever. I got into some weird stuff. I listened to Crazy Town. I got into the Beatles quite a bit. My girlfriend at the time, my kid's mother, she listened to a lot of pop stuff. So I heard Spice Girls quite a bit. What else? She listened to like the stuff that was on the radio, the popular crap. I mean, it's not crap, I guess, but I think it's crap. She finally got into new metal, stuff like Limp Bizkit and 3 Days Grace and Papa Roach, which I can do without Limp Bizkit. 3 Days Grace is older stuff's okay. Papa Roach's first album was fairly good. But I'm gonna listen to stuff like that. And then when we split, I went heavily back into the metal. I started listening to more and more metal and just heavy, heavy stuff. For example, Revocation, his first album, Empire of the Obscene. It's another grail for me on vinyl. I didn't really grab anything else for later in life. Because, you know, I don't have anything really. I got a lot of older stuff, nothing really new. New albums by older bands. So that's my contest entry for Brian's Vinyl Records 100 Subs contest. My childhood music, which isn't the greatest, but that's it. And I just want to say congratulations, Brian, for 100 subs. I think it was more than that when I'm recording this. It's like 118 or something like that. This is great. Hopefully someday I can get there as well. Maybe I'll have a contest. But keep up the good work. Keep getting the subs. And until next time, rock on.